Jay Albright. I'm the surgical director of sports medicine at Children's Hospital Colorado in the Sports Medicine Center here, as well as assistant professor at the University of Colorado Department of Orthopedics. What I want to talk about is anterior cruciate ligament tears in adolescents and young adults, and talk about really the journey that I've taken over the last 10 to 12 years and the successes that we've been afforded with the patients that we've been taking care of. I am the son of a surgeon. My father, John Albright, has been at the University of Iowa 46 years, almost 47 years, and I trained underneath him when I went through my residency. His bias at that time was always to use bone, tendon, bone, and never hamstring, tendon, and especially young females. The reasoning behind that has always been that if you permanently weaken the hamstring and you now have a higher, theoretically a higher chance of re-tearing that ACL, considering that one thing that we do know that we can modify as far as risks in female athletes is to do a training program where we, you know, neuromuscular train, and like PEP or Sports Metrics or FIFA 11 plus potentially, where we can decrease the risks of a female either tearing or re-tearing their ACL. So it's never really made sense to me to use hamstrings in young females. However, when I went through my training in both pediatric orthopedics and in sports medicine and for two fellowships, when I came out for skeletally immature kids, there was really only IT band for the really, really young kids with 5 or 6 years of growth remaining or more, and then hamstring tendon for the older kids that were still growing. So that never really set well with me. And so when I started out in practice, I started looking for a different method. And so I came across the work of others in adults looking at quadriceps with or without patellar bone. About 10 years ago, I started doing Allen Anderson technique or partially transfysial technique in kids that are young athletes, and done about 700 of them now. I use, if they're still growing or have more than a year, year and a half, probably 2 years of growth remaining, I'll do Allen Anderson femoral drilling technique, and then a transfysial on the tibia. If they have more than 3 or 4 years of growth remaining, you can go olipifaceal on the tibia as well. With that technique, we have had very good success. We've been looking at our results since I started using this, and we have about a 96% success rate with regard to a 4% re-tear rate. When you compare females to males, our study that's coming out soon has about a 1.8% rate of re-tear for females and a 5% re-tear rate for males. When we compare overall group looking at other techniques to what we're doing here, the failure rate in hamstrings is anywhere from 11 to 25%. And our failure rate, again, like I said, is about 4% for the quadriceps. Return to sport rates, we define as passing the return to sport tests that we employ, and then progression towards return to sport to their hopefully similar level that they were at before or higher. Our return to sport rates, by that definition, is around 89 to 92%, a little bit lower in females and higher in males. But we have a very, very competitive rate of return to sport compared to other techniques and other grafts. Approximately 500 or so patients that I've performed the surgery on that have considerable growth remaining, more than 2 years. We have zero growth arrests, partial or complete, no limb length inequality or genu valgum or genu verum in our results at skeletal maturity for the ones that are completely skeletal mature at most recent follow-up. The technique we have is simple and straightforward. It's very similar to Allen Anderson's original technique. We can use this with the quadriceps graft, and we can use the quadriceps graft in kids that are skeletally immature and kids that are skeletally mature as well, with very good success, just as been shown by the adult surgeons, or surgeons that do primarily adults, have shown as far as their success rates with the same graft.